I need to my oxygen, or how to say, my lungs need to work today, because today we're going up to 3,350. Maybe today or maybe tomorrow, we don't know.
Okay, we're just leaving a great camping spot there by the river there. Today we're going to head up the road, or climb up the road, to Song Kul, the lake Song Kul. It's 3,300 meter pass we have to go over. I'm not sure whether we'll do it today or tomorrow. We'll be able to do it at all. We have to see how it goes, whether we need to hitch a ride maybe, or we can cycle the way. We'll see how it goes. But we have enough food to camp for a few days, so we can take it slowly. Okay, let's see how it goes. We're now 2,200 meters in altitude, have a 16 kilometer climb up to 3,350. Let's see if we can manage that.
High now, and now we can begin to feel like the oxygen now, how much feeling in your lungs. Yeah, and we go up there.
Over that one.
Yeah.
In a few minutes it will start zigzagging up the mountain there. So now we're on the pass. Came up from down there. The valley behind me. It's just zigzag up the mountain. And in a few hours we'll be up there, believe it or not. Time for lunch. We are now, what is the height now?
We are 2,800 meters.
Yes. Well, nice place for lunch. What do we have for lunch today?
Bread, crisps and butter and
apricots and nuts. Yes, mm-hmm. Very good. Okay, just had lunch here, filled up our bottles in the spring over there, and let's carry on up, see how far we get today. If we get to 3,000, then that's the highest we've ever been, so see if we can do that first. Nothing Meadow and Jamie realised it yet, but where they are, about there, is about 3,000 metres. That's the highest we've ever cycled. That was the last pass we took. So from here, or from where they are, this is beating our own record. We've been high before, but not on a bicycle. Amazing now as we climb higher and higher. Jamie seems to get stronger and stronger. He's more at home in the high altitude here. That's what his body is built for. But we start struggling and gasping for air over 3,000 meters now. The air gets thinner and thinner now. You don't notice it at 2,000, but up to 3,000 you start noticing it. And Jamie just gets stronger and stronger. Okay, way in the distance now you can see the valley. That's where we were yesterday when we had that strange kind of dust storm. That's where we've climbed up to from, yeah, about this time yesterday afternoon we were there. Now we're here. I think the top is within sight. Who would have believed that was possible this morning? Peter and Jeremy once again showing just how good bike riders they are now. Riding up here on a loaded touring bike is not easy, and they're doing it. I didn't believe they could this morning, but they can. Amazing. What a surprise, Jamie's got energy to bike and talk as he goes up here.
But mommy cannot breathe not so much than me, I can. So you can try to go up to mom and see how she's feeling.
Is this the top? Is this the top? The impossible is possible once again. Oh, oh! Oh my goodness, mate. Woo! Oh, he did it! What? Well done! Whoa!
How is that possible?
Can you believe it now?
No!
You can stop believing in yourselves now?
No!
And about you?
How?
Whoa! Well done! Well done! Wow! Top of the world nearly.
Yeah, seems like it.
It feels like we are in the sky. biking.com and let's see if it's correct.
Guys, here from France, they've driven here in a Nissan Micro. See, you don't need the big Land Cruiser, and 1 litre Micro is sufficient. Or a set of legs. Okay, got a nice short break there. 15 kilometers down the road here, we should arrive in Song Kul. Maybe if we're lucky, we can stay in a yurt camp tonight. Up here on the highlands here, this is where the nomads, they come in the summertime. All this is snow in the wintertime. And here they come in the summer and graze their cows and horses. Hello! And there it is in the distance, Song Kul. I like it, an altitude of 3,000 meters. Really is beautiful up here, no wind at all, quite sunny now, and really worth the climb up here. Amazing, this is the image of Kyrgyzstan I've had in my mind for a while. Okay, just heading down here to Beish Yurt Camp. There's a few yurt camps next to each other, but we'll give this one a go. See if I got space for us here. And he'll get some food and everything. Let's see how it goes. Yeah, just been to ask how it works. Costs 1,200 Kyrgyz som per person. It's about £12 per person. And for that you get dinner and breakfast, and we can stay number 3 up there. How fantastic. And tomorrow there's a sauna. We have water. No internet though, so you'll have to wait a few days before you see this video. Okay, this is our yurt tent. First time you're ever staying in a yurt tent. What's it like? Let's have a look. What's it like in a yurt? Oh, there's 4 beds in here. Oh, it's nice and cozy. There's even a heater. Wow. I haven't tried that before.
And also, we think about we want to fish in that lake, and that is the next point. Tomorrow we will a little bit sightseeing on the lake, I think.
Fishing, yes.
Fishing.
Long time ago we found a place for fishing. So now we're digging all the warm clothes at the bottom of our bags that have been buried away. I'm wearing shorts and t-shirt for months now. So finding hats, finding woolen underwear and all kinds of stuff.
And we need gloves.
Gloves.
Everything.
This is the dining room. You can have tea here and coffee and all kinds of things here. Probably having our dinner. Half past 7, there's dinner here. Just call me better. Okay, where are we up here? Song Kul Lake. We didn't actually believe or didn't actually know whether we could get here on the bike, so whether it would take 2 or 3 days, but yeah, it was possible in 24 hours since we left the shop yesterday, so good riding everybody.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Yeah. So yeah, now we're here, we're gonna have free tea in the restaurant here.
Yeah.
And dinner, and we'll give us our breakfast in the morning, so I think we might stay a few days, and Jamie wants to go fishing and
yeah.
So that's it. Good day. Pretty
yeah,
good day.
Yeah, I think we will be here 2 or 3 days, I don't know.
Yeah.
Depends how we are feeling.
I think tomorrow and then we'll probably move on.
Yeah, we'll see.
I don't think there's that much to do here, but I think we'll here tomorrow have a rest.
Yeah.
So, okay. And it was luxury when we came here, we could have a bucket of hot water to have a wash in, so that was nice. So now we're all dressed and got all our warm clothes on that we never thought we'd put on again.
Yeah. So, okay, let's go and have a cup of tea.
Yeah,
okay.
That'll be nice.
Yes, okay. So okay. We'll have to do exploring around here tomorrow. Okay, so bye-bye. This is just heaven. Warm soup, warm tea, and nice dinner.
We are actually cold for the first time in a long time. Really.
But enjoying a nice dinner here. Looks like they've lit the fire. What's it like in here? Oh, and the fire's going. Perfect.
And the funny thing is, in the restaurant when we was eating, mommy was taking the chocolates, she was taking every food and saying to the cook, we need to have some more food.
Yeah, she was hungry today. Never seen her eat so much ever. But asking for more food and more bread and stealing things from other people's table. Oh dear. Oh.